No, it's not Tim Tebow, it's me again. I used to look like Tim physically until I quit working out, and it went away real fast, so. How are you? It does take courage to tell jokes like that. That is being courageous. But we figured you guys had had a lot of serious stuff, and so maybe sometimes laughter is like the thing that recharges your batteries, so. And you know, being courageous, I mean, sometimes it's like running into the line of fire or diving on a grenade, but sometimes it's just everyday life. Like when I turned 55, my cute little wife, the next week scheduled me my very first colonoscopy. By show of hands, how many people have had the joy of this experience? All right, this story is for the rest of you. And a lot of you may not know what I'm talking about. Let me break it down for you. In the Latin, the word colon means intestine. The word oscopy means to attach a camera to the end of a garden hose and ram it through. Pretty sure that's what oscopy means. But there's three steps to a colonoscopy. The first step is the pre-surgery consultation, which you're going to do a couple of weeks before the actual procedure. And let me say this, please pay attention during the consultation. And I tell you this not because I did, but because I didn't. No, I'm a comedian trying to get laughs, looking at the doctor going, boy, this is a tough job. No ifs, ands, or buts about that. Not even a smile. That's funny. I don't care who you are. That's funny right there. Second part of the colonoscopy is the day before preparation, because before they put this camera through you, they want you completely cleaned out. Well, my wife bought all the ingredients for the preparation, but she wasn't home that afternoon, so she had left them on the kitchen counter, and she kept texting me. Now, remember, at 3 o'clock, you're supposed to start the preparation. I'm like, I got it, I got it. Well, the first part of the preparation was you were supposed to mix 64 ounces of Gatorade with 10 large packets of Miralax. Now, the back of one packet of Miralax says, may cause loose and watery stools. 10 large packets of Miralax is guaranteed to clean out the Alaska pipeline. Now, if I had paid attention during the consultation, I would have remembered that I was supposed to spread the 64 ounces out over a period of 3 hours. I still don't remember hearing that. So I mix it all together and I down that 64 ounces in 8 minutes and 34 seconds. And I know because I timed myself so I could brag to my friends. Now the only thing remaining on the counter is a bottle of something called magnesium citrate. 2 drops of this stuff will pull the Eiffel Tower out of the earth. And I remember the doctor saying everybody needed to drink at least half a bottle, but some people might have to drink the whole bottle. And I thought, well, I don't want to have to come back later and do this again, so I pop the top, I hold my nose, and I chug the whole thing. Now, in just under 10 minutes, I have completed a preparation procedure that is supposed to take 4 hours. And not long after that, my stomach started making some noises. Noises like that fireplace in the Amityville Horror. Run through the bowels, run through the bowels. Get out. At which point my underwear tapped me on the shoulder and said, run. Off the ground. I was physically afraid, and I watch a lot of rodeo. The only thing I could think to do was put a glove on my left hand, get some rope, tie myself to the toilet seat, and hold on. I passed everything I've ever eaten in my entire life. I passed things I had only thought about eating. I passed things my neighbors had eaten. We keep in the garage. be legally declared mountain spring water. I was ready for my test. So I get up the next morning, I go down to the doctor's office. This was the part I was dread the most. Ended up it was the easiest of the three steps, thanks to a little IV they give you with Demerol in it. They put that needle in my arm. My last conscious thought was, I bet my doctor has a camera on her cell phone and I'm gonna be on TMZ tonight. I was out. I woke up, she's standing there. She's like, hey, it's all over. I was like, I didn't even know you did it. She's like, yeah, everything's great. You don't have to do this again for 5 years. I'm like, I'm really glad. She left. I had that little gown on and I sit up and I see my shirt and pants at the end of the bed, so grab my shirt and I start to untie the gown and I hear a woman say, what are you doing? Turn around, there's a nurse in there. I hadn't even noticed her. I said, I don't know. I guess I'm going home. She said, kiss again. I said, what's the problem? She said, well, in order to get that camera through you, they have to inflate your intestines with air and you can't go home until you give that air back. I said, okay, I will. She said, well, I have to verify that you do. At which point I noticed she's holding a pen and a clipboard. And I remember career day in high school. Nobody told us you could get paid good money for writing farts on a clipboard. Because I have friends that do that all the time for free. But here's the problem. I was raised in the South. My mother taught me never to do this in front of a woman, especially a woman I don't know. So even though I really need to do what she wants me to do, there's no way. I can't do it. I locked